Hey guys, today I just wanted to show you how you can use the ChatGPT API to start building really powerful Python functions really quickly. And we're going to be using prompt engineering, specifically few-shot prompting, which is basically where we give the model a few examples of the types of responses that we would expect to get from one type of answer, and that'll help train it just a little bit. The ChatGPT API is a paid service, so to get started, you'll have to have an OpenAI account and enter your credit card information, and then you'll get an API key that will be associated with your account. The first thing I do is import the OpenAI package and then give it the API key. Here I'm having it read it from a text file, but you can just paste the API key directly here. Then we define our function. This one is called is bigger than breadbox, and it takes in a prompt. And then we create this chat completion with the model GPT 3.5 Turbo, which is the latest version of ChatGPT. And then this messages list here is where we're going to do the prompt engineering. So we have roles, either user or assistant, where user is the person entering the question and the assistant is the chatbot's response. And here we give it examples and tell it how we want to behave. So the first thing I do is I say, I'll name something. You will respond true if it is physically larger than a bread box, false if it is physically smaller than a bread box. And then then the assistant says, okay, I'm ready. And the user says, a baseball. And then it says, false. An M1 Abrams, true. Joe Biden, true. A fruit fly, false. And then the last thing we do is inject our prompt, whatever it is, and then we're going to get back the response in this kind of format. So it should be either true or false, and it will have learned the rules that we want it to learn just based on these few examples. And then we get out some reply content, and the zeroth index in the list is the text of that actual message, and we just print it out. And so then we can call the function is bigger than breadbox with the string a grizzly bear, and let's see what it says. Okay, so a grizzly bear is bigger than a bread box, and we were able to write a function that could determine that in 26 lines of code, something that would be extremely difficult without natural language processing. Okay, so now I want to give a quick demo on how we can actually use this to do something useful. So these are a bunch of PDFs that I've downloaded from PubMed, and when you download these PDFs, you can see they have these kind of numbers and letters. They don't really correspond to any of the content of the PDF, and this is what a PDF from one of these websites would look like. So we have a title here, obviously, but we also have a bunch of other stuff, like an abstract, and whether it's a review article and the DOI, and then here's another one. And extracting this title is easy for humans, but it's not very easy for a web scraper or Python. But with ChatGPT, we can extract these names much more easily. And with prompt engineering, we can do it reliably. So this is a really simple function that takes a PDF, looks at the first page, and extracts the text from that page, and then it takes the first 400 characters of that text and gets rid of some of the new lines and special characters and just prints it out. So you can see when we do that, we get something like we get a DOI, we get internal medicine, we get some HTML stuff here, and then we do have the title in here, and then it's directly followed by all these authors. So extracting that with some kind of parser would be extremely difficult because all these different articles have different structures. So this program combines that prompt engineering with the PDF scraper to rename PDFs with the appropriate title. So I'll walk you through it. First thing is I just suppress some warnings because sometimes PDF readers have trouble interpreting some stuff. Same thing, we have the API key. This is the same thing that we did before. We basically just open up a given PDF. We look at the zeroth page, which is the first page. We extract the text. Then we just look at the first 400 characters because usually the title is going to be in the first 400 characters of the first page. We replace any new lines with a space so that it's all just a continuous piece of text. and then we get rid of any special characters, and we return that cleaned up first 400 characters of the first page. And this is where we do the prompt engineering. It's the same thing as the bigger than a bread box example, except the examples that I give it are the first 400 characters of random PDFs, and the answer that I supplied was the title. So I said, I'll give you the text of the first page of a scientific paper or article. You will reply only with the title of the article. Do not include any punctuation or special characters in your response. Okay, I understand. I'm ready for the transcript. And then I gave it a few examples where I gave it some of these transcripts, and then I supplied it with what the correct title is. And you can see, for example, in some of them they have web pages, some of them they are missing spaces, or it has trouble getting certain word letters out. So it's able to, so when I gave it the correct answer, I told it exactly what it should be. And then what we do is we get the response after we retrieve the answer from the prompt. So we give it these examples, and then we say, okay, here's the transcript that we want you to find a title for. We get that answer, and then this part is kind of hacky, but I'm just replacing these special characters, whether it's a colon or a comma, because we can't have those in title names if we're going to use those title names to rename a file. And ChatGPT still puts special characters, even though I told it not to. So then we return that reply, and then all this does is it calls those two functions and looks through a list to rename those PDFs. So I'm supplying it with this folder containing random papers, so we'll just run that and see what happens. Okay, so over here I have the papers that I want to rename, and I've specified the directory that they're in, so I'll just call it. Okay, so it renamed this one Colorectal Cancer in Inflammatory Bowel Disease Mechanisms and Management. So let's see how close it got. Yep, that looks good. What about this one? Frontiers in Immunology Review. Tumor Endothelial Marker 1. So that one it didn't get quite right, actually. But I think... So it should be NYESO1 Based Immunotherapy of Cancer Current Perspectives. And it's not quite right. Let's try this one. Gene Therapy for Cancer Treatment Past, Present, and Future. Yep, it got that one. Immunotherapy and Prevention of Pancreatic Cancer. Yep, got that one. Metabolic Adaptation in Hypoxia and Cancer. Yeah. So you can see, it's not perfect, but in less than 50 lines of code, we were able to write a program that could rename PDFs in a way that would have taken a lot longer if we'd done it purely with Python programmatically. Thanks for watching.